the research questions that still need a lot of attention, and we'll talk about a subset, are issues of function and task allocation. So the human does what, the machine does what. Issues of trust, and also misuse or incorrect use and confusion. Issues of attention management, which are age old because they really are much like human cognitive biases. They're part of the cognition that we bring to the task of interacting with the AI. The issue that some of these technical questions are not purely technical questions at all. So this is the challenge of working on this one. You may need an anthropologist or sociologist to weigh in. Regulation and explainability. The ethical and social dilemmas that come from the emergent behavior of AI systems as we're designing with them. Thinking about the human experience, right? So making sure that if I, as the human, am interacting with the machine, it's treating me humanely. And I realize that sounds like the system would become Terminator and like stop treating me humanely. I don't mean it that way. I mean more like if you could develop a system that queries the human when it's uncertain, and you can recreate essentially a two-year-old that's just saying, what is this? Why is that? You know, what about this? What about this? And it can become very burdening on the human, even though it was designed to kind of maximally help the computer help the human. It became a burdensome interaction. The first theme from that list that I want to focus in on is task allocation. We've inherited from human automation interaction this particular hierarchy that I think is very helpful, right? So from at the low end, specifically, the computer offers no assistance. The human must take all decisions and actions. Then we move up. The computer offers a complete set of decision action alternatives, but makes no recommendation. The computer narrows the selection down to a few, so it pre-filters and doesn't show you every option you have, but amongst the filtered set, you have complete autonomy to choose what you want. Next, we have that the computer suggests a particular alternative. Now we're starting to cross over into the AI driving the interaction. We have the AI executing the suggestion if the human approves, then allowing the human a restricted amount of time to veto before automatic execution, executing automatically, and then telling the human what it did, informing the human only if it asked, what did you do? Informing the human only if the computer decides it's necessary. And finally, the computer decides everything acts autonomously, it completely ignores the human. It's not just that a system is at any one level. You can think about the automation level at multiple steps along the process of interacting with the system, right? So from the point of acquiring information or analyzing that information or selecting a decision or implementing an action, right? At each point in the process of doing something and being assisted by AI, you could have more or less of this, a higher or lower automation level. So I think it's good to look at this older scholarship as we consider new problems, because it's, you know, so tempting to say, today is uniquely hard, right? But I'll just point out that in this flow chart, when people are thinking about automation specifically, you notice that they're looking at evaluating their choice of level of automation for a given task by considering workload of the human involved, situational awareness of that human, their complacency, how willing they are to kind of be like, the computer's probably right, right? And also skill degradation, right? Over time, I think you see this with, say, being able to Google for an answer. We remember, if we have an expectation that we can Google for something later, we're actually less good at remembering it. Skill degradation is a real possible outcome. There's a bunch of cognitive biases out there, right? Because we don't know there's too much information. We need to act fast. We don't have enough meaning. So as you are designing systems, I would implore you to think about which of these cognitive biases, and I know there's too many to go over them individually, might negatively affect the human that you're trying to interact with as you're designing the intelligent system. The first group of principles for human-AI interaction is what is happening initially, right? Making clear what the system can do, what it can't do, right? And making clear how well the system can do it within that regime of what it can do. Think about examples of systems that do the time services based on the context, that display contextually relevant information, that match relevant social norms and mitigate social biases by, say, ensuring that the language and behaviors do not reinforce undesirable or unfair stereotypes and biases.